You know what, man? We're going to go back to the roots, you know. It's cliche. It might sound like, you know, growing up, I didn't have nothing. Everybody says that. And seven people in one bedroom with just one bed. You know, you always wanted the nicer things in life, you know. And if it was a Jordans or if it was just a nice pair of sneakers, my parents couldn't afford it. You know, my parents couldn't say, hey, we're going to go buy you a new pair. You know, my parents always say, you know, if you really want something, you got to work for it. And, you know, I've seen my mom send me to basketball camps and not have food in the refrigerator, but because she wanted to make me happy, she made it. And that was showing me how to work. And I used to look at people like, man, I wish I could have that. But how can I get that? You know, we was all born the same way. And it's just like, I always wanted to be fashion, if you want to say. Like, I want people to look at me like, yo, that dude's a stylist, like he does this. Good advice for anybody that's trying to get into the styling game is you gotta be patient. You know, you can't expect to blow up overnight and, you know, become a Rachel Zoe or a Monica Rose overnight. It's not gonna happen. Like, you have to put in your time. And I think a lot of people, not only if it's styling or if it's real estate, whatever it may be, they just want, hey, I want it to happen right now. And it comes, it's just like anything else. You gotta work at it and you gotta stay focused and you're gonna hit some hurdles. But you gotta learn how to fight back. My own personal style is simple, you know what I mean? It's classic, it's simplified, but yeah, it has a little splash of edgy to it, you know? It's not conservative, it's not over the top, you know? But it still has that when you walk in the room, like, oh, okay, well, he has that on, or he has these pieces on. So I just learned how to mix and match. That's my best way, learn how to mix the high end with the low end and just make it work. You know, obviously I work with D'Angelo Russell, also work with Draymond Green right now. I've worked with Jordan Clarkson in the past. You know, Big Baby, unfortunately, he's not in the NBA right now, but worked with him all last year. And a couple other people that are not just related to sports. You know, I would deal with Brian White as well, he's an actor. And here and there, you know, we get some editorial work. You know, we've done some editorial work as well, so. There's a lot of difference between all the players I style. They all have different, you know, swag, if you want to say. You know, some guys like the oversized, some guys like the tapers, you know, so you just got to really learn what they like. You know, I know, for example, like Draymond, he always loves his, you know, Mary jeans, right? He loves Saint Laurent, you know. Then you have D'Angelo, likes the oversized a little bit and still wants to be, you know, with the tailored jeans. But you just got to really learn how to relate to your client. And to me, it's more like a project. And you gotta study each individual for who they are. And, you know, sometimes you gotta take it outside of basketball and relate to them, like, off the court. Like, what do they like to do? So then you can kind of incorporate those kind of things and then move forward and kind of get what they really are and who they are as far as fashion goes. Actually, I do design as well. I think a lot of people seen some of my work at All-Star this week, and it was good. And on All-Star weekend this year, with Draymond rocking a couple of the pieces, you know, from the fur coat that got a lot of buzz to, you know, even the button downs he was wearing underneath it. What athlete has the best style? Gotta go with LeBron. You know, he's just smooth. You know, he got the suits, you know, sometimes he wear a peak coat. I just like his versatility. You know, he doesn't try to do anything that's loud or over the top. You know, gets right to the point. I'm here for business. I look like I'm here for business and get it done. Half of them, you know, come from nothing. And you know, once they get money, they think that I need to go buy what's loud and what's expensive and just to stand out. And I think that's where they go wrong. It's just like anything, you need guidance. And, you know, they just go and buy whatever is on the blogs and it's $2,200. Because it's $2,200 doesn't mean you're gonna look fly in it. And I think that's the number one mistake they make. Draymond's my guy, you know, he's funny. You know, we talk about all kinds of stuff. But last year when I was working with Big Baby, man, he's so funny. He's just so cool. And they both get excited about the clothes. Like, they be like, oh, where you get this from, bro? It's like, we're like, yeah, we're gonna swag this out. It's a toss-up between them two. You know, I'm grateful to be, you know, friends with him first. the number one hurdle, I think, anybody that starts their own clothing line, and that's that financial backing. You know, and people don't think that how much it takes to make a piece and to adjust and make sure that, you know, it fits right. And all that takes money and time. And that's, you know, two things that's the most valuable thing that anybody has is money and time. But you have to have a passion. You got to find a way when it gets down and that garment is not fitting, you have to find something inside of you and say, you know what, I'm going to get this to work. You know what? I don't think this business affects my relationship life. I feel like the people that are around me, my core group that I really genuinely care about, they understand the grind and they understand what my bigger picture is, and they're supportive. And I think in anything you have to have a supporting system. You know, if it's your mom, sister, your best friends, like they know, like, all right, you know what, Vic, you gotta fly out. But when I have time, you know, they know I make time. And if I have to show up for something that's important, it might be there 10 minutes, but I'm gonna show up. Having that support system that works so hard that you can achieve anything you really need. And I haven't achieved what I want yet, but it feels good to know that I'm headed in the right direction. And the progress, I enjoy it every day, man. And it's a blessing to know that I can go to Saks or I can go to Neiman's. Before, I don't even think any of my family back home know what Neiman's or Saks is. Like, they don't care about that stuff. You know, they care about whatever they have on their back already. They don't care about if it's 10,000, if it's red bottoms, or if it's, you know, the newest bag. They don't care about that. So it was always, you know, work for the best that you can be in your lane. If you want to be a dancer, be the best dancer. If you want to be a stylist, be the best stylist. But everybody in their own crafts has something in common, and they all work hard for what they want. That's where I'm at right now.